flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
Hiya, Comp. Today is Tuesday, October 8th, 2013. I'm George.
And I'm Zach. And it's time once again for KTV Live Intergalactic.
So, Zach, we have a 2-in-1 comp right now. We have Respect Week and Earth Week.
That's great. It's better than the Chili's 2-for-20.
It is indeed. And yet again, it is jam-packed Tuesday show.
Yeah. We got to get it right into it.
Yes, so let's get into that. This week in space history, Pioneer Venus 1, a spacecraft, ended its mission. Pioneer Venus 1, also known as Pioneer Venus 12, fuel supply exhausted, stated space.about.com. The orbiter ended its mission as a meteor flew through the dense atmosphere of Venus. According to NASA, the Pioneer Venus 1 is a twin spacecraft with Pioneer Venus 2. As the Pioneer Venus 1 went into the Venus atmosphere, it produced a glowing tail like a meteor. Pioneer Venus 1 is also called Pioneer Venus 12.
This year's Nobel Prize winners in physics goes to François Englert and Peter Higgs. They were given this award for proving the existence of the Higgs boson, also known as the God particle.
This week's KTV holiday is World Space Week. According to NationalAwarenessDays.com, this holiday celebrates the advances in space science around the world and the ways it has improved our lives. The United Nations General Assembly declared in 1999 that World Space Week will be held each year from October 4th to 10th. Listverse.com reported that we are moving through space at the rate of 530 kilometers a second.
Recently, a Native American tribe has requested the Washington Redskins to change their team name. This is the case because the mascot represents an Indian and the tribe is taking this offensively. A debate about this topic is still going on.
So we have Joe here with sports.
I'm here with sports. So yesterday in football, the Jets bested the Atlanta Falcons in a close game of 30-28.
That's terrific.
In preseason basketball, the Atlanta Hawks lost to the Miami Heat in a game of 92-87.
Saw that one coming, yeah.
Toronto Raptors also beat the Celtics 97-89. And finally, in baseball, the Atlanta Braves lost to the Los Angeles Dodgers in a nail biter of 4-3.
Well, so that was really interesting. And we have a game for the boys after school.
So, yeah, I hope we win.
Yeah, so do I.
All right. Back in the news.
Hockey is one of the most important sports in the world, and in the U.S. there are 30 major teams. So let's pass it over to Ross, who is able to find out some of the most popular NHL teams of the Comp students.
Thanks, Zach. So as you said, hockey is one of the most popular sports in the entire world. It's in the Olympics, all these huge competitions, and I was able to get some students here in Comp, and they were kind enough to tell me about their favorite NHL team.
My favorite hockey team is the Philadelphia Flyers because I love the Eagles.
My favorite team is the Pittsburgh Penguins because most of my family's from Pittsburgh.
My favorite hockey team is New Jersey Devils because I like Mario Brodeur.
My favorite hockey team is the New York Rangers because they won the original six teams.
I like the Toronto Maple Leafs because they are good at getting in the penalty box.
Of the six people we questioned, two picked the Devils as their favorite team. One picked the Flyers, one picked the Pittsburgh Penguins, one said the Rangers was his favorite, and one chose the Toronto Maple Leafs. I also asked 50 Comp students, excluding the six that are in the video, and 50% of them chose the Devils as their favorite team, while 34% of them chose the Rangers. Also, the other 16% went to the Penguins, Red Wings, Kings, and Avalanche.
Hockey is one of the four major sports in America, along with baseball, basketball, and football.
Today's KTV birthday is Bella Thorne. FamousBirthdays.com stated that Bella Thorne is known for her starring role in Disney Channel's original show, Shake It Up. Bella Thorne plays the character of CeCe Jones, a leading dancer who gets in a lot of mix-ups with her best friend, Rocky Blue. Her role is played by Zendaya. Bella Thorne also was on other TV shows like Wizards of Waverly Place and HBO's Big Love. Today, Bella Thorne is turning 15 years old.
So, George, we're midway through the show, right?
Yes, and we have a flyer over there with Jonato and Benner.
Let's go over there.
Yeah.
Yep. So, Brenner, I hear there's a haunted house
in your
park.
I know there is. I mean, I think you might get scared if you go. I've seen you in horror movies. It's not pretty.
Definitely. And it looks like it's on Saturday, October 6th, from 7 to 10 p.m. So if you guys are interested in that, just make sure you get there. So back to you guys in the studio.
To get back into Jam-Packed Tuesday. So let's go. Do it. There are many reasons why we are living right now. You might not know all of these reasons.
In our solar system, Earth is the only planet that can sustain life. Why is this?
Earth can support life because it has all the elements necessary that we need to survive. For example, it has a climate, it has an atmosphere, it has oxygen and water. And it's one of the only planets that has liquid water.
Water is believed to be the most important chemical necessary for life because it contains the oxygen needed for life. It is drinkable for humans to consume, and it allows life-providing molecules to move around easily. Earth has a suitable climate. This is caused by the moderate amount of carbon dioxide in the planet's atmosphere, which is constantly refreshed whenever there's volcanic eruption. The temperature on Earth does not go from one extreme to the other. The last important factor in life on Earth is the sun. If there was no sun, there would be no life on Earth. Technically, Earth probably wouldn't exist either. Because of Earth's ideal distance from the sun, it receives a perfect amount of heat and light to allow life to be created and to support it.
According to NatGeo.com, Earth can sustain life for another 1.75 billion years.
In gym, classes have been participating in football. With teamwork, teams that may start off slow could end up being the best team out there. Football, volleyball, and gymnastics takes place in gym class.
Hello, George. I'm here with the weather.
Yeah, so we have Jeff here.
Today will be sunny with a high of 70 degrees. Tomorrow, Mr. Sun will be hiding behind the clouds with a high of 64 degrees. Thursday will be a little nippy and a high of only 60 and showers. And lastly, Friday will come along with 62 degrees and rain.
Well, so, you know, it's not looking the best out right now.
It's not.
That's pretty disappointing.
I know. All right, see you later, George.
See you.
This week in the state of New Jersey, it is Respect Week. The color of this week is orange. When was this law passed? Is it A, December 1st, 2010? Maybe B, January 3rd, 2011? Possibly C, September 20th, 2009? Or is it D, November 22nd, 2010? This week of respect was designated to help students learn empathy, respect, acceptance, and personal responsibility. And the answer is D, November 22nd, 2010. This school tier stated, just because it is Respect Week doesn't mean you stop being respectful after this week. Remember, always be respectful. According to martialartsforpeace.com, every 7 minutes a child is being bullied.
Speech students, today is Mrs. Colby's speech day, so remember to go to speech today during your cycle classes.
George, we're almost done with the show,
yeah.
Right?
But yeah, we have a preview. Actually, this is the end. It's the end of Jam-Packed Tuesday. I'm pretty upset.
It's all right, because, you know, we got a show tomorrow.
So for even more KTV news, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, YouTube, or Twitter. For Zachary Thorne and the rest of the KTV news team, I'm George Conti. Have a terrific day. Peace and carrots.